欢迎大家嚟到香港浸会大学持续教育学院举办嘅网上资讯日啦。咁今日咧，我哋系呢一场咧就系浸会大学自治学士学位课程关于文学院嘅课程嘅。咁介绍我自己先啦，我系今日嘅主持。咁啊，嚟自我哋浸会大学自治学士学位学务组嘅同事啦，我系 Connie 啦。咁喺呢个正式开始之前咧，我都想讲讲我哋呢个场次咧系讲通识及文化研究文学史嘅。咁同埋。另一個課程是音樂學文學士啦。咁喺開始之前咧，亦都希望大家留意啦。咁成個講座嘅過程咧，請大家唔好錄音、錄影或者拍攝。咁所有嘅投影片嘅資料咧，同埋視頻記錄咧，淨係用於今次嘅講座。如果未得講者同意咧，請大家就唔好使用呢、這個即係相關嘅任何影片或者記錄啦。咁今日我哋呢個講座咧，通識教學文學嗰個課程咧，我哋係請咗阿 Dr. Gladys Zhang 同埋音樂學咧，我哋請咗Dr. Austin Yip 嘅。咁我事不宜遲，將時間交俾阿 Dr. Zhang， 唔該多 Zhang。
多謝曬 Connie 嘅介紹啊嚇。咁我係Dr. Zhang 啦，係通識文化研究文學學士嘅學位課程老師其中一位啦嚇。咁我哋個課程咧就係喺文學院裏頭人民及創作系裏頭嘅其中一個 program。咁你去到呢個 website 咧，你會見到我哋有三個 program 嘅，咁就 humanities 啦、creative writing 啦，同埋liberal and cultural studies 啦。咁今日我就會講呢個嘅，咁我都介紹下我哋嘅系裏邊嘅唔同嘅同事啦嚇。咁我試下 share 個 full screen 啊，咁會好啲係咪啊？麻煩大家等一陣先啊，睇下啊，咦？點解？唔好意思啊。好，咁呢個會唔會清楚啲？係啊。係啦，咁我哋係主任啦，就係羅桂祥教授嘅。咁我哋副系主任咧就係Dr. Daisy Tam 嘅。咁我哋 program 嘅 director， 咁我哋個係依個課程嘅主任啦嚇，就係Dr. Peter Locke 嘅。係啊，咁個課程裏頭有四位老師嘅。咁第一位就係Dr. Lucetta Kim 啦嚇，咁佢就副教授啦。咁另一位就係我啦嚇，咁Dr. Gladys John 啦，咁我都係副教授。咁跟住就頭先我介紹過嘅係課程嘅主任啦嚇 ，Dr. Peter Lock 啦，同埋Johnson 啦嚇，係嘅。咁我哋課程裏邊有即係主要，我諗我哋大家都好想就係、是、介紹到同學可以學到跨課程同埋跨文化嘅一個課程啦嚇。咁等間我介紹嘅時候，你會見到啲課程內容其實好豐富啦。咁都包括咗依個跨學系同埋跨文化咁呢個嘅課程嘅預覽嘅嚇，咁我哋都希望即係同學喺學完我哋呢個課程之後，就會首先啦就會即係懂得通識文化學習嘅認識啦嚇，咁呢好多時都係喺即係 classical 嘅 period 啦，咁我哋講緊文藝復興時候開始嘅一啲典故啊嚇，咁從裏頭咧同學就可以認識到中國同埋西方文化嘅一啲傳統文化歷史啦。咁從認識到之後咧，就希望同學係學習到一個批判嘅思考啦，嚇。咁唔單止係即係對文化，亦都對藝術上面有一個認識嘅，嚇。咁依個就係我哋即係希望同學學完成個 program 之後得到嘅嘢啦，嚇。咁同埋咧嚇，咁我亦都希望同學就係即係喺學習裏頭會有一個即係文化藝術嘅認知啦，咁依個係好重要嘅。即係譬如話你去睇一個畫，咁你要知道個畫嘅背景同埋佢點解會即係被推崇為一個名畫啊？啊，咁依啲係我哋希望同學學啦嚇。咁同埋即係譬如話啲哲學嘅理論，點解佢哋重要嚇？咁唔係淨係話佢哋重要咁簡單，而係裏頭明白到我哋都可以點樣用到佢啦嚇。咁同埋就同學可以學到即係溝通啊、分析啊、依啲即係好重要嘅一個即係。技能啦嚇，咁從而咧就培養同學有一個 argument 啦，會有一個獨立思考批判嘅能力啦嚇。咁係啦，依個就係我諗我哋成個 course 希望同學得到嘅一啲即係重要嘅技能啦嚇。咁同學畢業即係讀完成個 course， 希望即係大家都會學到一啲就係對即係文化對人生啊嘅一個思考啦嚇，同埋會學懂就係即係點樣同其他人一齊合作。咁我哋好多 project 好多課程裏頭嘅一啲 assignment 啦，都係希望鼓勵同學即係學懂同人合作做一個 project 咁啦嚇。咁同埋點樣樣喺個時候即係個世界變得咁快啦，點樣學習一種能力去適應呢個變化咧啊？咁同埋就學懂即係融會唔同嘅思考方法嘅。 係啦，同埋會即係學懂即係點樣樣去即係支持自己，即係睇一個即係一個知識啊嚇，一個 value 啊，咁同埋就係即係去懂得去即係為自己社會服務啊嚇，咁呢啲就係一啲我哋即係希望大家同學可以得到嘅一啲技能啦嚇，咁最理想嘅就即係自己可以即係有一個自我嘅認知啦，同埋有一個更加好嘅一個溝通技巧，咁呢都係培養同學即係。第時出嚟做嘢嘅時候，一啲好重要技能啦，啊，咁我成個 course 裏頭咧，就係要同學即係 Year Three、Year Four，咁呢個係 Top Up Degree 啦，嚇，咁 Year Three、Year Four 咧，大家係要攞到66個 unit 嘅，咁其中咧Major Required Courses 啦，嚇，咁就係即係必修科，咁就係36個credit 嘅，咁而可以選擇嘅科嘅 credit 咧就係30個 credit。咁成個 degree 啦嚇，同係需要128個 unit 嘅，咁其他66個 unit 咧就將會喺即係譬如話你 AD 啊，即係 associate degree 啊，或者其他院系畢業嘅一啲分數裏邊combine 埋一齊嘅。OK，係。咁呢啲你見到我哋個課程嘅架構啦嚇，咁 total 就有4個 semester 嘅，咁就 year three year four，咁第一個 semester 啦嚇，咁你見到必修科係有3個，咁可以選擇嘅科目咧係2個啊，咁第一個 semester 就希望大家可以攞15個 unit 嘅，咁適應完之後啦，第二個 semester 啦，咁就會收多一科，咁就有3科係 major 嘅必修科，咁另外3科就可以選擇科。咁第二個 semester 咧，就要求同學會應該會可以完成18個 unit 嘅嚇。咁第三個 semester 啦，即係 Year 4嘅時候咧，第一個 semester 咧就要3個必修科，跟住加2個選修科。咁、那個 honor project 咧，同時都會計分嘅。咁成個 honor project 咧，就應該係第一年嘅第一年 semester two 開始就安排噶啦。咁喺第4年啦嚇，year four 啦嚇，佢嘅第一個 semester 已經係開始係要做緊，咁係計3個 unit 啦，成個 total 嘅 honor projects 咧係6個 unit 嘅，咁你見到佢係分開2個 semester 咁計啦嚇，咁第四個 semester 咧就必修科係1個啊，咁其他3個係選修科，咁就希望同學有時間就可以完成佢嘅 honor project，咁 total 咧就會有66個 unit 嘅，係啦。咁你見到啦，依、这個就係我哋即係必修科一啲名稱啦嚇。咁、你見到係即係有基本嘅，譬如話 Introduction to Welsh Civilization, Cultural Studies, Artistic Creativity and Arts Appreciation，到慢慢會有即係 Level Four 會深啲嘅，可能就係即係 Honor Project 啦，就你學以致用，點樣用喺自己嘅一個 research project 裏頭，係啦。咁呢啲就可以有我哋總共有24個 courses 係可以俾同學揀嘅。咁就喺2年裏頭，你可以選擇一啲你自己有興趣。咁你見到我哋有個課程都好廣闊啦嚇。有譬如話文學一啲嘅，譬如 fairy tales、detective fiction 啊，咁亦都有創作寫作嘅，譬如 personal writing 啊，咁或者係theatre 啊，咁亦都有啲譬如話社會媒體性重啲嘅，譬如話 understanding media culture、sex and gender in media、in the media，咁有啲更加即係另類啲，譬如講 globalisation 都有嘅，哲學意味重啲嘅都有嘅，譬如話 rethinking cultures east and west，咁你見到個課程係好廣闊，咁都希望即係其中即係可以包可以俾同學有唔同嘅興趣啊嘅培養啊嚇。咁都適合唔同同學嘅興趣啦嚇。咁另外咧，我哋其實今年咧已經開始咧就會有 internship 嘅啦，因為可惜啦嚇，COVID-19 嘅關係咧，呢個 internship 咧就推延到下個 semester。咁即係話，如果同學係會申請我哋會讀我哋嘅話咧，咁9月開始咧就可以考慮咧做呢個 credit bearing 嘅 elective courses 啦嚇，咁就可以。有幾間，即係我諗total 依家我哋有10幾間嘅團體啦嚇，咁就話應承咗可以俾我哋嘅同學去做 intern 嘅。咁其中一個就係譬如話 Hong Kong Art Centre 啦、藝術中心啦嚇，咁女同學社啦、活見香港啦、Walk in Hong Kong 啦嚇，國際特赦組織香港分會啦、辛苦女協進會啦嚇，咁個類型都好多嘅，咁都希望同學即係從 internship 嘅過程裏邊，會培養到自己一啲技能啦，同埋揾到自己嘅興趣啦。究竟未來做嘢嘅時候有啲咩係特別自己想做嘅咧？嚇，職業嘅培訓啦嚇。咁喺 很多時候在 interview 的時候呢，同學都會問到的，就是我們的 program 畢業的同學呢，未來的工作情況是怎樣呢？那我們過往我們都會做一些 statistic 啦，一些 survey 啦，那就看到很大部分同學呢，畢業生呢有五成以上呢都會在媒體和創作工業裡面工作的。那另外呢，有三成呢就是從事教育的，那另外有兩成呢就是其他類型。那我都認識有同學是做 finance 的，咁係啦，有同學可能係做咗social work 嘅都有嚇，咁嗰個你見到個層面其實係即係我哋個課程係好廣闊啦嚇，咁培育嘅知識係可以用到喺唔同嘅工作上面啦嚇。咁我鼓勵都同鼓勵同學嘅，咁畢業嗰年啦嚇 ，graduating class 咧，我哋有唔同嘅獎學金啦嚇。咁最高 GPA 嘅同學有6000蚊嘅，第二高嘅 GPA 有4000蚊，咁呢個係一個參考啦嚇。咁而未畢業嘅班咧，咁個最高 GPA 同學咧有3000蚊，咁第二個咧就有2000蚊。啊，咁你見到即係就算我哋都鼓勵同學即係都要適應啦。咁如果你係即係嗰個改善啊，有個 improvement 啊，最大個 improvement 嗰個同學都會有獎學金嘅。咁你喺裏頭見到，咁我哋好鼓勵同學即係學習啦。我亦都過往嚇，即係除咗 COVID-19 一個 exception 嘅時候啦，我過往係搞咗好多嘅活動嘅。咁就希望同學就唔單止係即係喺課堂裏邊學，都可以走出課堂，走出課室裏邊去其他嘅場景度學啦。我哋有譬如話 film appreciation 啦，啊咁亦都做過 field trip 啦。譬如我哋同 Walk in Hong Kong 合作過嘅，譬如話喺灣仔、深水埗唔同嘅地方去認識個區嘅特別嘅歷史啦嚇，亦都會用到譬如話 museum exhibition 啦，咁譬如香港歷史啊、文化博物館啊，佢哋唔同時段有唔同嘅即係 thematic 嘅一啲exhibition 啦，咁我哋都會即係同佢哋交流，咁希望佢哋可以俾到一個導賞團嘅，咁都過往係做過好多依類型啦，咁依啲圖畫啦，雖然唔係圖畫係相啦嚇，咁大家係見到即係老師嘅參與啦嚇，咁好多同學都參與，咁佢裏頭都學到好多嘢，咁都即係佢都好。過往經驗就係同學都好中意呢啲即係導賞團啦嚇，咁我亦都有搞，每年都會有搞一個即係文化交流團嘅嚇，咁我哋搞過嘅，譬如話去雲南大學啦，香港同內地高考生嘅交流計劃啦嚇，亦都同台灣嘅國立清華大學一起合作過交流團嘅，咁過往同學都去得好開心，學到好多嘢，因為其實 intensive 嘅，因為都會有兩個禮拜左右嘅時間啦，咁十日至兩個禮拜時間，咁同學係好開心嘅，啊唔同嘅地方嚇，學到唔同嘅文化認知，咁你見到佢哋裏頭嘅相嚇，係啊。咁同時我哋都舉辦好多唔同嘅講座啦嚇 ，seminar 啦，譬如話emotional capitalism 啦嚇，咁亦都講到 politics of life 啦嚇，咁同埋犬兒到狗智啦嚇，咁啲哲學性啊、文藝性啊唔同嘅類型嘅活動我哋都搞過，我哋每年都會搞即係 alumni 嘅 career talk 啦。我諗同學即係兩年時間 top up， 其實好快就預備要工作，咁都好想知道究竟即係畢業生。他們學到的東西之後他們會怎樣找工作、啊、他們的路怎樣走、啊、都希望認識一下畢業的同學的，我們每年都會搞、就算是現在 COVID-19 我們都會在網上有個 Zoom 的 talk 的，同時有、性別文化節啦，這個都是每年會做的，同志電影節啦都是每年會做的，這個就大概我們的、就是、program 裡面包含的活動，你看到裡面有些 poster、啊、不同的 talk、啊咁我過往個經驗就係同學都好積極參與，同埋都好開心嘅，即係有依啲唔同嘅場景啊，即係唔同嘅唔同人嘅講法啊，可以即係參與認識到唔同嘅睇法啦嚇。咁係啦，好多謝大家今日嚟即係聽呢個講座嘅，咁希望你哋如果有問題就可以問啦嚇，係啊。
係。同學，如果我而家呢個 moment 咧，即係唔該曬 Gladys 啦。咁如果呢個 moment 又冇嘢想問，但係一陣間聽下music 嘅時候都仲有嘢想問翻 Dr. John 咧，你哋可以喺個 chat room 嗰度咧揀翻阿 Dr. John 嘅名，咁佢收咗你哋嘅 question 咧，佢就會遲少少答你哋噶啦咁樣。又或者你呢個 moment 想發問都可以嘅。
係，唔該你 ，Connie。
三線係咪冇問題住？咁同學可以諗一諗先，咁一陣間用翻個 chat room 嗰個 function 去問翻 Dr. John 都得嘅。咁我見到阿 Dr. Yip 喺度噶啦，咁我都先唔該阿 Dr. John 先，咁我將時間交俾阿 Dr. Yip。
Now, let's begin. So my name is Austin Yip, and I'm the Program Director of the Bachelor of Arts in Music Studies. Today, we'll be talking about the admission of 2021. We'll look into the curriculum structure, what are the possible jobs that you can do in the future, the admission requirements, and some of the FAQs, and we'll also give you the contact information if you need, and so that if you need to find us and ask us more questions in the future. The program itself is a self-funded undergraduate program. It's normally understood as a top-up program. So students normally would come here when they have finished the associate degree or higher diploma in music. Or some students also do this as a second degree. In the past, we have students who have graduated in UST, for example, or CUHK for a four-year full program, and then they would like to change the career path and come back to school as for BMS 3 and 4. And then going further for other studies. This is a program that is jointly offered by the Department of Music, HKBU, and CIE together. Normally, students finish everything within 2 years. If you don't come from the BU AD program, then you might need to make up a few courses, but I think so far in the past, most students finish in 2 years, even though for those of them who don't come from our system, you probably have to retake a few, like make up a few courses in the AD, in AD program, but that shouldn't be a big problem. We have a few students doing this every single year. The program covers a lot of different classes or courses, including comprehensive studies in musicianship. We'll have two courses in advanced musicianship. We also look into theory, into analytical skills, into how to look at, for example, set theory in the 20th century. We also look into, for example, sonata form, figured bass, like German Lied in the 19th century. We also look at history. We'll look into, for example, history from Bach until the 21st century, what is currently the most updated things that people are composers are doing or artists are doing in the field. We also look into creative approaches to applying musical skills in the society, including, for example, we look at music and business that is listed here on the third point, as well as conducting. We'll have two courses in conducting, the conducting and the advanced conducting. And then there will be music advocacy that we look at art. For example, last semester, we look at what pandemic has done to art making and how music functions in the society, as well as looking into next semester, very likely we look at NFT, like how people have been looking into encrypted art form and how that deals with music playing and how that combines with all kinds of different art forms. You will also have opportunity to perform. We have a lot of orchestras and ensembles here. We have a big symphonic orchestra. We have smaller chamber ensembles. We have wind symphony. We have three choirs, and we have a lot of smaller chamber ensembles. So there are a lot of experience for you to learn how to perform, and you also have private lessons. And normally, you'll be doing 54 units as major core courses and 12 units as major elective courses, meaning that every semester you will have a chance to take an elective course of various kinds. Year one and two, it's the thing that you have done in AD or HD or possibly other university before. Major core courses include what I mentioned to you earlier on as advanced musicianship. So we'll be studying on how to do more melodic dictation, rhythmic dictation, as well as more complicated way of playing, for example, 4 against 3 with 2 different hands. Also including chromatic sight singing, like atonal sight singing, atonal dictation, and a lot of things like this. There will be also about history from Bach to Brahms, as well as Mahler, Debussy, and the global era. And we also look at research methods for those of you who are interested in taking a research degree in the future. We'll also prepare you very well from that perspective. And we'll also look at theory in the class of analysis, tone and post-tone theory. Art in context is what I mentioned to you earlier on, as looking into what art functions and how music places itself in the society. In Introduction to Music, Entrepreneurship and Business, we'll look at how music can be seen as a business, how we as a musician also have to think about ourselves in in a business way. How can we write round proposal, for example? How can we get funding from various sources so as to support our creative ideas? And we also have ensembles. At each semester, you'll be graded by playing in different ensembles, including the choirs and orchestras and things like that. You also have music practicum. That will be each semester, we are giving you 13 lessons, private lesson by professional musicians in Hong Kong. They are like the top players in Hong Kong, very often players from Hong Kong Phil, as well as a lot of very fine players. You can find the full list on our department website, which I'll give you at the end of today's presentation. And you'll also be doing an honors project while you go to BMS4, that you have three different choices. The first is the recital, second is lecture recital, and third is a thesis, a research thesis. So the recital will be a 35-minute to 40-minute recital of your own choice, and then you have to audition in order to get that position so that you'll be able to perform in public, 35 to 40-minute recital. Lecture recital is a 15 minutes plus 15 minutes program where you talk about your idea, your research idea, and then you play your program, a 15-minute program of roughly 2 to 3 pieces, depending on what piece you choose for the lecture recital program. Or you can also think about doing an honors project in thesis, which you do a research project and then supervised by our very fine teachers here. And there are also other major elective courses. This varies every semester, and normally we have 3 to 4 choices every semester for students to choose from, including, for example, chamber music literature and performance, orchestral performance and literature, where we'll look into the standard repertoire of these ensembles, and then we also look at how to perform them in the live situation. We'll also look at conducting, where you'll be conducting your classmates. You will be studying from very fine conductors in Hong Kong for fundamentals of conducting as well as advanced conducting. We'll also have music education, instrumental pedagogy, and piano pedagogy for you to learn how to teach the instrument, because a lot of the students here currently are already instrument teachers, and they would like to learn more on how to teach instruments so that they can deliver a much better lesson plan or what to do in various settings. And we also have introduction to music therapy as an introduction course to what music therapists would have been thinking, what they would normally do, and how they can eventually, if you want to be a professional music therapist in the future, what are the possible paths that you have to undertake in order to become a professional music therapist. There's also classes on world music, and we often have some special topics in music, depending on who is in the scene or who is in the community, depending on various semesters. Like the last program, we also have internship. Our students have been working in a lot of different organizations in Hong Kong, including, for example, PPHK, Hong Kong Composers Guild, and a lot of private recording studios. So there are opportunities for you to work in internship, and that would definitely help you to build your CV in the future. So what would people normally do in terms of a BMS program? A lot of them are performers, either performing for, let's say, commercial production, pop concerts, or like some private events, weddings, and things like that. Some of them would like to be a conductor, that they would conduct ensembles in many places. A lot of them become an administrator, like some of our past students are currently working in West Kowloon, Hong Kong, as well as Hong Kong Art Festival, and a lot of places in Hong Kong that they also try to build their own company so that they can exercise their creativity from the things that they learned from school as well as outside school. A lot of them have been working as instrumental teacher since or even prior to their arrival to the department, and then they continue to do that after they graduate. And recently, a lot of our students continue for further postgraduate study, including the master program here at BU, and some of them would go to, for example, CUHK. Some students go to foreign countries, including in the past, we have had students going to Guildhall in UK, and we also have students currently studying in the Netherlands, and we have students everywhere in the States, and it's totally possible. It really depends on how you plan your study and plan your career and plan your what you really want to do. For yourself. And admission requirement, normally we would need an associate degree in music studies or an equivalent qualification from any of the local or overseas recognized institution, or NHD from any recognized institutions. So these are the two basic requirements that we normally would need. If you have other qualifications, then please send us an email with your concern, with your qualification, and then we'll let you know whether you're being qualified for that. On top of that, we would need a grade 8 in ABRSM practical or its equivalent. Now, of course, if you don't come from a background of taking grade 8 practical exams, for example, if you come from a state, then there are also equivalent thing that certificate or equivalent examples or experience that you can show us that you have achieved that level. So that would be like a minimum requirement. And nowadays it's much easier than last year, especially you can take the exam in an online mode and you can get the result very, very quickly. So it shouldn't be a problem nowadays. And also grade 8 in ABRSM theory. Now, if you come from an AD program in music studies or an HD in music, then you probably have taken theory courses of roughly grade 8 or AMUS-TCL level. So let us know, and then we will let you know whether you have met the criteria already. Finally, candidates who possess equivalent qualifications are to be assessed on a case-by-case basis, meaning that if you don't have an AD, you don't have HD, you don't have the grade 8 practical or theory, let us know. We'll tell you whether you have met the minimum requirement or the equivalent requirement, and then we'll be able to tell you whether you are capable of applying. Shortlisted candidates will be invited to attend a written exam and interview / audition should the program deem it necessary. For example, prior to now, I was working on the whole day of admission. So we'll be looking into your application and we'll see whether you're being invited to come and talk to us in person. There are some questions that are frequently asked. For example, what shall I do if I don't have a grade 8 theory certificate? Answer, you may submit equivalent qualifications to fulfill the requirement. For example, pyramid music theory study in AD or HD music program. Number two, what shall I prepare for the audition? Now, we need audition tape. Nowadays, it's easier than the past where you can record everywhere of your own interest, and then you can record the performance of your playing. We need two contrasting pieces. Now, what would mean by two contrasting pieces would be, for example, pieces from two different periods, or two pieces that are one is fast, one is slow, or one is more lyrical, one is more agitated, or one is more contemporary, and the other one is more conservatory. So make sure you provide two contrasting pieces of your major instrument. We don't really look into minor instrument here because you don't have time to think about minor. It's a 2-year program, it's short, and we want you to focus on your major instrument so that you'll be good. Number three, do we welcome mature students? Yes, we do. We welcome students of all age groups. We do have mature students. And what we really look into is whether the students fit into the community. So we have mature students and we have students who freshly graduated from AD to create a very nice mix. Finally, do you have a chance to play in the orchestra or sing in the choir? Yes. Now, as I mentioned before, we have choir, we have orchestra, and we have small ensembles. Each of these individual ensemble will require a separate audition, meaning that if you are interested in singing in cantoria, which is our best choir here, or very limited spaces, then they will have the individual audition. And then if you fail, you probably go to BUC, BU Baptist University Chorus. And then if you don't get in, then there is also the women's chorus. And if you don't get in, there is also other ensemble. You'll be at least in one of the ensembles, depending on how you perform. There is also our CMHK, which is a very fine chamber ensemble. We have the BU Symphony, we have the string ensemble, we have the wind symphony, we have the saxophone ensemble, we have the percussion ensemble in the past. It really depends on year by year basis of the smaller ensembles, but the big ones are always there. So it depends on how you play and how well you play. So if you are interested in a program, you can contact Connie all the time. She'll be able to answer you basically 99% of the questions. For the 1%, then she will refer back to us. then you can send us an email to mus-bms@hbu.edu.hk or call us at 3411-7866. Thank you very much.
好，唔該曬 Dr. Yip。咁同學喺呢個時間都爭取一下機會啦。如果有啲咩想問啊 Dr. Yip 或者 Dr. John 啦，可以而家問啦。又或者我頭先講嗰個方法咧，你可以喺個 chat room 裏邊揀翻相對嘅老師，咁佢就會睇到你 question， 跟住會答噶啦。咁容許我喺呢個時候大家諗緊有咩問題嘅時候咧，我都做下少少廣告啦。咁啱啱呢一兩個課程我哋都係仲係接受緊報名嘅。咁詳情咧可以上翻我哋 CIE.HKBU.EDU.HK 個網站啦。咁我哋嘅 email 係 SPA 啦，即係self-funded program 嘅 admit 嗰個 email account 就 SPADMIT 係我哋 email account 咧 @hkbu.edu.hk 嘅。咁隨時有需要可以打電話俾我哋啦，3411-3044呢個係我哋嘅 hotline。咁呢啲 information 喺我哋嘅網站度都可以隨時揾得到噶啦。咁在这个时候大家还在想有什么问题的时候呢，我都想大家帮我们做一做一个讲座的问卷，我会在 chat room 那里打出来的。这个就是我们今天的讲座，我们很希望大家可以提供宝贵的意见，大家都可以一会去我们这个大会的展览厅浏览所有的课程资料和其他你们有兴趣的课程都可以的，有任何疑问都可以即时查询。这样我们再看看，如果没问题都没问题的，刚才 Dr. Yip 都讲了他有很多的联络方法，请大家可以事后过了今天之后，请大家可以用任何的方法找我们相关的课程主任或者是老师，如果不是就找我们就没问题了。同学都应该没问题的了。咁我哋今日好多谢大家出席呢一个讲座啦，咁我哋呢一个场次就去到呢个位完结㗎啦。唔该晒大家，唔该晒多 John， 唔该晒多 Yip。